A very good morning, my dear students. How are you all? Okay, I hope that you all are fit and fine at home. Okay, so let's start today's computer class. In today's video, I'm going to start a new chapter, chapter 3, log on to Access. Okay, so what is Access? Actually, Access, it's a product of Microsoft. It is an application software which is used to store and manage data. Okay, it is used to manage huge amount of data stored in a database. Okay, so now there are many questions like what is data, what is database, okay, what is the use of database. And Microsoft Access, MS Access, it's actually a RDBMS, means Relational Database Management System. So starting with basic concepts, just what is data first, okay, what is data? So data, any raw fact and figures that we collect are called data, okay. Data means any information about student, their name, addresses, contact numbers, these all are data, okay. But remember that data in unorganized form is called data, but when it become organized, then it is called information, okay. And what is a database? So a database is the collection of or organized collection of data, okay. In database we can store huge amount of data in a proper way, okay. We can organize the data easily, we can manipulate the data. Manipulate means we can make changes in data very easily. So a database management system or DBMS is a computerized record keeping system, and it allow you to create, modify, store and extract information. Extract means nikalna, fetch karna, okay, accessing information. Using DBMS, we can easily search data, we can easily modify data, because whenever you store the things in a proper manner, so it always easy for you to search the things and access the things, okay. Now let's come to database management system, okay. Database management system. So let's recall again, a database is information that a person needs in his personal, business, social and religious life, and the power and purpose of information is not only in collecting and finding them, but more importantly in using them. So yes, of course, whenever we store any data or information, so of course we want to use that data or information, and for easy use of data and information we need a system, an organized system to store that data or information. So that organized system is provided by the database management softwares, okay. So there are two types of database management systems. First is called the flat file database and second is called relational database. So in flat file database we cannot link the records, but in relational database we can link the records, okay. So MS Access is a relational database management system, okay. So first of all I will show you that how you can open MS Access in your system, okay, and then I will discuss more about the structure of database. So for opening MS Access in your system, first of all you have to click on the start button and then click on all apps or all programs, then search Microsoft Access, okay. Choose MS Office first, because MS Access is a tool in MS Office suite, okay. MS Access, here it is, Microsoft Access. Okay, so this is the very first window of MS Access, which you will see after clicking on MS Access. So here we create databases. Okay, here we create databases and then we store data in created database. So for creating a database, first of all you have to click on this blank database option. There are many options. You can also use these online templates for creating database, but I am telling you the simplest way. You can create a database directly by clicking on this blank database option. As you will click here, so in this window you have to specify your database name. So like I'm writing HRAD Hridesh data, okay, and click on the create button. As you will click on this button, so you can see our database named with Hridesh data is created now. Okay, it has been created. By default one table will be there. In this table, a table which is the collection of rows and columns, in this table you can store your data. Okay, so in this MS Access window I would like to inform you about the structure of database. Here I will explain you the structure of database. So basically in this structure we have a very important element which is called table. You can see here table. It is very important part of database. Okay, so tables are the built-in blocks in any database. It is combination of rows and columns. In these tables you can store your data in a tabular format. Okay, in this table you can store your data. Okay, and there are some elements in table like, see, ID. This ID is called a field. Okay, whenever you create a table, so you need to specify field's name first. So what this ID is, it's a field name. What it is, it's a field name. The field specifies the heading of the column. Okay, next element of table is row. These lines are called rows in which you can store your data. It represents a record. Okay, then data means whatever you store in your table is called data. Either it is text or number or anything, it is called data. Okay, so a table is consist of three main elements: fields, records and data. Okay, and for creating a table, what you have to do first of all, just do right click on a table and open it in design view. They are asking for the name std and click on OK. Now your table is created. By default one field will be there, another fields you can write. Subject. Okay, these three fields I have taken and now I'm closing it. So you need to save it first. Now I'm double clicking on this table. You can see your table is created with three fields: ID, student name and subject. Here you can specify ID, you can write name here and you can write subject here. In this way you can add multiple records in your table. Okay, so just write any name. Right, in this way you can store records in your